On the occasion of inauguration of the 21st World Congress of Mental Health, being held in New Delhi, on the dais present Union Minister of Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Dr. Harshvardhan, Secretary, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Mrs. Preeti Sudan, President, World Federation of Mental Health, Dr. Gabriel Ibijaro, President, World Psychiatrist Association, Dr. Helen Herman, Chairpersons of the World Congress, Dr. Sunil Mittal and Dr. N.K. Bohra, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I am happy to be here to inaugurate the World Congress of Mental Health, being organized by the World Federation of Mental Health in partnership with Caring Foundation and other institutions. Before me are approximately 1,000 delegates participating in this conference. I would particularly likely to welcome the 300 odd international delegates who are representing about 50 countries. I understand the World Congress is taking place in India and in fact in South Asia for the first time. This is a matter of pride for all of us. Frankly, it has come here at an appropriate moment. Mental health issues are acquiring a serious magnitude in our country. The World Health Organization reports that India has among the highest prevalence of mental illnesses globally. Our National Mental Health Survey 2016 found that close to 14% of India's population required active mental health interventions. About 2% suffered from severe mental disorders. Nearly 200,000 Indians take their own lives each year. If one includes attempted suicides, the number goes up substantially. These are worrying statistics. It is also a fact that those living in metropolitan cities and those who are young, whether in the productive age group, our children, our teenagers, are most vulnerable to mental illness. In India, both these factors are cause for concern. We have a young population with 65% of our people below the age of 35, and our society is rapidly urbanizing. This leaves us staring at a possible mental health epidemic. Friends, given the figures I have just outlined, it is an irony that 90% of Indians in need simply don't receive mental health care. There are several reasons for this, and I hope they will be addressed in this conference. The biggest obstacle that mental health patients have to encounter is stigma and denial. This leads to the issue being ignored or simply not discussed. In some cases, it leads to self-diagnosis that is unsuitable or could even worsen the situation. It may even lead to other extreme steps. As a society, we have to fight this culture of stigma. We need to talk about mental health issues and treat ailments such as depression and stress as diseases that can be cured, not as guilty secrets that must be pushed under the carpet. In this context, I am glad that advocacy and awareness are important components of the Government of India's National Mental Health Program, as was outlined by our Minister of Health. This program is building 22 centers of excellence in the field of mental health. In parallel, the district mental health program has already covered 517 of the approximately 650 districts in India. It is taking the conversation about mental health to the grassroots of our society. To spread awareness, it is important to build partnerships between the public and private sectors and between the government and civil society organizations. It would also be valuable to stitch together community support networks in some measures. These can fill the gap being created by the gradual breakdown of the traditional joint family system, especially in our big cities. Sometimes this results in young people being left with the impression that they have no one to speak to, no sounding board, and no informal counselor. This could then become the first step towards depression. A second major gap in combating the mental health challenge is that of human resources. India is a country with 1.25 billion people, but just 700,000 doctors, less than 1 million. In the field of mental health, the scarcity is even more acute. There are only about 5,000 psychiatrists and less than 2,000 clinical psychologists in our country. This number is extremely inadequate, and we need to act, especially for the purpose of diagnosis of mental illness. It would be advisable to use physicians, psychologists who teach in colleges and educational institutions, as well as auxiliary nurses and midwives who are at the front line of our public health system across the country. I am told information technology and telemedicine are also coming of aid. Such technologies are linking doctors and counselors in cities to mental health patients in rural areas. As internet penetration expands in our country, this holds much potential. Friends, I am glad to learn that in addition to advances in neurosciences, as well as our understanding of the clinical causes and treatment of mental disorders, the World Congress will also have sessions on yoga, meditation, and traditional approaches to mental health. It is vital to tap into our wealth of traditional knowledge and link its learning to modern research on mental health. This will promote a holistic approach to mental health care and can combine the best of different fields of practices. The example of yoga is very instructive. When people talk about yoga, they generally refer to the psychological benefits. However, the mental, psychological, and cognitive benefits of yoga are equally worthy of our study. I look forward to receiving feedback on the deliberations of the special session planned on the role of yoga in battling anxiety and depression and in preventing the onset of mental health problems. In conclusion, I would like to re-emphasize that India's mental health care challenge is capturing a society in multiple transitions. From traditional diseases, it is gradually non-communicable diseases that are emerging as a major threat to our people and their well-being. This is part of the worldwide trend. And many non-communicable diseases are either rooted in or associated with mental health issues. All of that invests this World Congress with urgency. At the end of this conference, we should be closer to a time-bound program that will ensure the quickest possible accesses to mental health diagnosis and treatment services for every person in need. All of you in this hall, and I include international delegates here, are stakeholders in this effort. You will be performing a genuine nation building and humanity building task. I wish you and wish the conference all success. Thank you. Jai Hind.